So we'll do just a quick recap with number three being pretty much the most straightforward. X minus 2 times x plus 5. We'll do it the long way and then the short way. The reason why I have made you at least practice the long way a little bit is because it makes us less dependent on other people to tell us how to do things. All we need to do here is distribute. And we distribute again, and then we have it. If I tell you some shortcut that you then have to remember, and then hope you don't forget or remember incorrectly, then it makes you weaker. So I'm trying to make you stronger. So a quick reminder that if I want to multiply something by x plus 5, like 5, for example, well, I'm going to distribute the 5 to both of these, I get 5x plus 25. Again, if I do something else like a y, multiply y by x, looks like yx or xy, however you want to write it, and y times 5, 5y, standard way to write that. Okay. Well, if I were to distribute something even more crazy, whatever it is, whatever this thing is, which I'll represent by a blank set of parentheses, if inside there we have a palm tree, thank you. Okay. Well, if I'm going to multiply these parentheses by a palm tree, then I distribute palm tree, you know it's nonsense, I multiply it by x, and then multiply by 5, so I get
palm tree x plus
palm tree x 5. Oh, see, it's not going to be nice, is it? Maybe we have palm tree times x plus 5 times a palm tree. Whatever we're multiplying the parentheses by, these parentheses, we just distribute it into parentheses. And the same is true for whatever we see. So I'm just going to distribute this parentheses, the x, into the 5. So I get parentheses x minus 2 times x plus parentheses x minus 2 times 5. Cameron, what do you think? Make sense?
Yes.
Okay. Distributing the whole parentheses, x minus 2 times x minus 2 times 5, there it is. Now, how do we continue on from there, Caleb? How would you propose that you move forward from there?
Distribute the x into that one.
X squared minus 2x is what we get there. Then plus.
Distribute the 5 into the.
Distribute 5 and get 5x minus 10. That's why I like to call it double distribution. I distribute the parentheses, and then I distribute this into the parentheses. Two distributions. X squared minus 2x plus 5x, that'd be plus 3x minus 10. So we keep piling it on and realizing that just understanding distribution allows us to simplify fairly complex expressions.
I'm gonna write down a step.
Write down a step?
Like, I understand how to do it.
Well, you know, I'm not gonna mark you wrong if you have work that supports your answer. If your answer is correct, your work doesn't have to look exactly like that. This is just a reminder of what's going on behind the scenes here. Let's go to number 5 because that's slightly more complex, but not much more. So you have this plus 3x plus 8, right, just kind of off to the end, but that will be like one of the very last things we do because there's this multiplication that needs to happen. Addition and subtraction as far as the order goes last. But I have two parentheses that I want to distribute. I could distribute this parentheses into that one, this one, to that one. It doesn't really matter. So might as well switch it up. Let's distribute x plus 7 to the x and to the 4. X times x plus 7 plus 4 times x plus 7. Both of those terms get x plus 7 distributed to them. And then we distribute the x into this parentheses, x squared plus 7x, or into the same set of parentheses, 4x plus 28, plus that 3x plus 8. Collectively turns to x squared, that's the only guy around. 7x plus 4x, that's 11x, plus 3x, that's 14x, 28 plus 8, that's 36.
Distributing twice. Double distribution.
So the thing we talked about last time was as human beings, we can't help but as we continue to do the same thing over and over and over to look for patterns and therefore shortcuts. Every time I distribute a set of parentheses to the terms in another parentheses, and then I look at the next step, all that happens there is this x, right, is going to have to be distributed into that x plus 7. That's what happens here. The 4, likewise, would have to get distributed into the x plus 7, just like the x did. So we could take advantage of that pattern and say, I'll just take the x and distribute it to the x plus 7 and just get right to that step right there. X squared plus 7x, I'll make sure to distribute this 4 into the parentheses and get 4x plus 28, and then the rest is the same as what we did in this other one. So whether you write out the step of distributing one parenthesis to each term in the other parentheses, or what you do here, which is what we commonly call FOIL. You guys heard of FOIL before? We are doing FOIL, it's just that we're not calling it FOIL, because FOIL is an acronym that some very nice teacher somewhere in history tried to do a very nice thing and make up this acronym that helps you remember how to multiply two parentheses together. But as soon as you don't have two parentheses with two terms each, FOIL doesn't apply, and people don't have a skill they can apply to the next scenario. They just have this disjointed memorization trick that they can't apply to any other situation but two terms times two terms. Which is why I don't even bother using it. We'll do one last one, number 2. X plus 5 times x squared minus 2x plus 3 plus 2x minus 8. I'm just going to take this x plus 5, distribute it to there, to there, and to there. X squared times x plus 5 minus 2x times x plus 5 plus 3 times x plus 5 plus 2x minus 8. Here's the double part of double distribution, the second round of distributing. X squared times x is what?
X cubed,
yeah. And that x times another x is just x times x times x, x to the third. X squared times 5, 5x squared. Negative 2x times x, it's going to be a negative 2x squared. Negative 2x times 5, negative 10x. 3 times x, that's going to be plus 3x. 3 times 5, that's going to be plus 15. Plus 2x minus 8. There's a lot going on. There's a lot of terms to look through. It might be helpful to go through and circle any like terms of x cubed. And maybe put a square or a box around the x squared terms. Maybe underline the x terms. I guess the ones that don't have any markers on them are the constants. So we have x cubed, a couple of x squared terms, 5x squared minus 2x squared, 3x squared, Negative 10x plus 3x is negative 7x. Negative 7x plus 2x is negative 5x. And 15 minus 8 is 7. If there aren't any questions, then I'm going to have you do a homework review. Question, Cameron.
Yeah, so do I have to do the homework review? Somewhat sort of not following.
Okay.
It's
what
just,
are you following?
Okay, I kind of sort of get it.
Uh-huh.
But then I got like this stuff going on.
What stuff do you have going on?
Like, I'm not even sure.
All we're doing though, just like we distributed the 5 x times two, x times x times two, and x plus 7, x plus 4 times x times x plus 4 times 7. We're just distributing what I'm going to do with the x plus 4 times 7. But I think that's okay. Just like we distributed the 5 x times 2,
this one, it seems like all this is like,
so here we have a basic, x plus 2 times 3x minus 5. All right, go ahead and do it the double distribution way, the long way, where we distribute x plus 2 to the 3x. Nice. We distribute the x plus 2 to the negative 5. Now to continue from here, we're going to have to distribute the 3x into the x plus 2 parentheses, so 3x squared plus 6x. We're going to distribute the negative 5 into its parentheses that it's multiplied by, negative 5x and negative 10. So we have 3x squared, 6x minus 5x is x, and the minus 10.
John.
Added 6, 5, you say you got 11?
Yeah, I'm accidentally adding 5.
So you just didn't get that negative on the 5x?
Yeah.
Okay, watch out.
Do you care if we put 1x or just an x?
I don't care.
Because they are the exact same thing. And if you have negative 10 plus 3x squared plus x, you know, that's fine too, because that's the same thing. All right, so continuing here, we see we need to multiply these two parentheses together before we can really proceed. So we have the 2x, and at the end we have plus 2x squared. And here we have, you know, whatever this parentheses times that parentheses is. This time, instead of doing the long way, the double distribution, I'll just use that pattern we talked about. Notice when we distribute the x plus 2 to the 3x and the negative 5, in the next step we see that 3x gets distributed into x plus 2, negative 5 gets distributed into x plus 2. So we could just do that from the beginning. We could just take 3x and distribute it to 5x and 4. So 3x times 5x is 15x squared. 3x times positive 4 is positive 12x. Then distribute the negative 1 to the 5x, that's negative 5x. Negative 1 times 4 is negative 4. If you did this in-between step, you're going to find you get the exact same result. Or for those of you who are wanting to cut this step out, that's what it would look like.
Okay.
15x squared plus 2x squared is 17x squared. Let's go ahead and check off that I've taken care of that.
Yeah, that's one thing I wanted to know. Is it okay if you, when you're done using those, if you just cross them out?
Sure. Just make it not too heavy a mark so I can trace back if there's any mistakes.
Yeah.
Fine. 2x plus 12x, 14x minus 5x is 9x. So, check, check, check. And minus 4, that's the only constant. There we go. 17x squared plus 9x minus 4.
Done.
Questions about that? Okay, so we have simplified expressions, we've learned about distribution, we've learned about double distribution, and it's, I mean, we're kind of at the end of a simplifying expressions unit, so we'll go ahead and take a quiz, not now, but next time. So I'll give you some time today, I'll hand you some review materials you can review. Yes?
What are we going to do after this one? That's distribution.
Oh. I think we're going to do a really quick version of solving linear equations. Let's see how much of that is stuck with you from last time. Because supposedly we've gotten through about chapter 5, which is solving linear equations, graphing linear equations.